Welcome to our Link G4 Plus live training session part 5 using our RB25 swapped S14 drift car. In our last video, we learned how to map out the full throttle area of operation, so fuel and spark timing off of our wastegate spring level. We were left with about 13 to 14 pounds, which is the spring pressure that we have in our internal wastegate assembly. In this video, we're going to learn how to start to work with our 3-port boost solenoid and turning up the boost in our closed loop format. I'm going to be showing you how to set up your targets and closed loop boost, how to set up your base wastegate duty cycle table, and then learning how to work with the PI and D values in our stage 1, 2, and 3 of the closed loop operation. We're going to have a ton of things to cover here. Let's jump into our live training session so we can get started. Welcome back to our live training session here with our RB25 swapped S14 drift car. In our last video, we finished the full throttle tuning on the wastegate actuator spring level for this setup. We made about 420 horsepower, we dialed our fuel in, we dialed our spark timing in, and we set up our knock control that was working fairly well. At this point, we're ready to turn up our boost and see what kind of higher power level we can make and what kind of boost pressure we can generate from this. Now this does have a 3-port boost solenoid. It is going to be the boost solenoid that the EFR BorgWarner turbos utilize. So it's going to be that factory BorgWarner boost solenoid mounted right onto the compressor cover. It's going to be trying to control our TurboSmart wastegate actuator. That has about a 13 or 14 pound actuator spring in it. We were seeing about 187, 190 kPa off that spring pressure on that last pool. So we want to turn it up past that. I want to be around 18 to 20 pounds of boost. So I want to be around 220, 230 kPa in that range. I want to just increase my boost and I want to use closed loop control to go in and actually control the solenoid and to hit my boost pressure. That's going to allow it to be consistent day to day, year to year. It's going to be the way the OEMs always program the boost control, and that's the way we want to program here. So what we're going to do is jump from our main fuel tuning and we're going to go all the way across into boost control. So let's go across here into our boost control. So we have an open and closed loop method. We're going to go right into closed loop and we're going to set this up. Now the open loop method simplifies the boost control process where we just put a duty cycle in and it gives us X amount of boost out. That is not going to be ideal in this case because we can run a closed loop control. If we have our air temp changes, if we go from a really cold day to a hot day, the boost won't be consistent. It has no way to feedback on itself to be able to make adjustments. The closed loop control is going to act just the way our closed loop fuel correction is going to be working. So we have our target lambda, our actual lambda. It knows the difference and it adjusts the injector pulse width by a certain percent to hit that target air fuel at any given time. We're going to have the exact same thing here with our boost control tuning. So we want to take advantage of this so it's consistent as possible. So the first thing we're going to do is jump into boost setup here, into boost mode, and we're going to go here and go into from open loop into closed loop, and we'll click OK. Now the activation here, we're going to set this to 2,000 RPM and higher. We want the boost to come in and start to activate. We're going to say here map activation. It has to go above 100 kPa for the boost control to turn on and start to do something, so that's fine. We don't want it active in vacuum, so 100 kPa and higher is what we need to be reaching. The activation timeout, that's going to be how long it waits to turn itself off after it drops below 2,000 RPM and 100 kPa. So in this case, we want it to shut off as soon as it drops below these conditions because we don't need the boost solenoid running, so 0 seconds is what we want to have here. The multiple boost tables, we're going to find that we have the option to do up to 3 different tables or a interpolate between. So we can basically have 2 different boost target tables, 2 different boost wastegate duty cycle tables. In this case, I'm just going to do 1 table here to keep things simple in this video, so we'll click OK. The boost table ratio table is going to be specifying how we want that switching to happen between these different table options. If we choose 3 tables or interpolate between or 2 tables, we're going to be specifying how we want it to switch from table 1 to table 2. There are going to be all kinds of conditions for that. We're not utilizing that, so we can keep that just kind of blank. We're going to have our boost PID set up here. So we want to talk about this and make sure that this is very clear. First thing we need to know is that in our closed loop method, we're going to have our base wastegate duty cycle. And this is going to be specifying what the duty cycle should be at the boost target that we want to be at. And we have it based on engine RPM, and right now it's based on throttle position. This table needs to be re-indexed, so we're going to be basing it on boost target and engine RPM. So we can be very specific with this and dial this base table in so that when we're requesting a certain target of boost, it's going to hit approximately that target because our base wastegate duty cycle is dialed in. That's going to be part of our job and our calibration process. In order to do that, in our closed loop method here, we want to make sure that our P, I, and D values are zeroed out. So it's effectively bypassing any of the closed loop PID control that could be going on in the background, and it's going to be simplifying things here. So in this situation, we're going to be leaving these zero and running into what's essentially called a simplified closed loop method, where it's just going to be where we specify a target and our target table, where we want the boost to be at, it looks up here in our duty-based duty cycle table what that duty cycle should be at, and it just runs that duty cycle. So it's gonna be essentially just a basic lookup. When we are ready and we get this base table dialed in here pretty well, then we're ready to turn on the closed loop feedback where it can make adjustments to the base value to get the duty cycle in line, to get the target boost,
Thanks for checking out our teaser clip. If you want to see the rest of this video and more than 500 hours of current EFI training we have to offer, make sure you click right here. If you want to go and check out more teaser clips from this training course, click here. And you don't want to miss any of the videos we're going to be releasing on this channel, so make sure you subscribe and click here. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys later.